Alright guys, welcome back to another exercise execution video. Today we're going to be taking you through the dumbbell incline press. So, first of all, you're going to need someone with you for this to support you, either to lift the dumbbells in place for you. It does make it a lot easier rather than flicking them back yourself. So, when you want to get yourself in position, first of all, you've got to pick up the dumbbells. This is, again, like I said, one of the harder movements to get right first. Especially getting your back into the right position because you're trying to maneuver the dumbbells as well. It can be difficult, so I would suggest having someone lift them for you. But anyway, so you set that nice and strong. Take your breath in as you go back. So kick them back into place. And then what you want to do is, you want to try and set yourself up while you've got the load on you, which is why I said it was difficult. So what you're going to do is you're going to try and retract your shoulder blades as you're doing it. So what this is going to do, it's going to put you in a much better position to be able to press with your chest. So what we're focusing on with this exercise is pressing with the chest. Obviously you've got the front of the delts in there as well, the front of the shoulders, and you've got some tricep in there too. But what you want to do is you want to think about almost rolling back first to create that arch in your back. That little minor arch is just going to allow everything to function as well as it could be. Put your chest up nice and proud, and then you're simply driving up with a slight conversion. So you're coming in a little bit. So what you'll see is actually coming across your body rather than straight up your head in front of you. This is going to allow for a peak contraction of the chest as well. So anyway, we'll go into position. So we'll kick them back, get into that nice position, chest nice and wide, and then you drive up and converge in, we'll squeeze the pecs, and then come back down slow. So what you want to do with your elbows as well, a lot of people flare up wide with a lot of pressing exercises. They flare up wide, and what happens there is the chest actually doesn't do all the work. It moves a lot into the shoulder and rotator cuffs. That's why you hear of a lot of people getting rotator cuff issues. So what you want to do is you don't want to come in completely neutral as well, like a close grip press. You want to go about somewhere in between where it feels most comfortable for you. So we'll go into that again one more time. So you kick it back. Get in position first, feet nice and strong, pressing into the ground, and then drive up and squeeze. And then slowly center, it's always controlled, and then drive up. Again with this, you don't have to come all the way down, right? It's just, it all depends on your mobility. So do what feels good for you, but a lot of people will always come down too far, and again, not put stress on the shoulder joint. We don't want to be doing that, we want to be targeting the chest muscle. So yeah, I hope this helps. Thank you, and I'll see you soon.